Phương Dung xin kính chào quý vị khán giả của VNTV. Hôm nay Phương Dung rất là vui và hân hạnh được chào đón bác sĩ Dr. Nasa Abu đến VNTV của chúng ta ngày hôm nay. Để nói đến một cuộc sống mà mình phải có được một cái hạnh phúc và một sức khỏe mạnh và để chống lão già ở lão hóa cho để mình già đi vừa đẹp vừa trẻ với một tuổi già, thì hôm nay Dr. Nasa Abu sẽ chia sẻ với chúng mình những bí quyết để thành công trong cuộc sống hạnh phúc, vui vẻ và trẻ đẹp. Welcome Dr. Nasa to VNTV today. Can you please introduce yourself and tell us about a little bit about what your passion and specialty in the medicine were?
Dana, it's so good to be here and to be in the presence of this very vibrant Vietnamese community here in San Diego. You know, thank you very much for being an audience. You know, I specialize in geriatrics or senior care medicine. So during that process, you know, of having trained here at UCSD, I came to familiarize myself with the concept of aging, what contributes to the aging process. What I also figured out that for imparting excellent healthcare, we have to mix the Eastern and the Western values of medicine. So that's what we call it integrated medicine. So I am also trained in anti-aging and functional regenerative medicine. And what I have seen that amalgamating or just mixing these two modalities actually does wonders for our patients.
So as you notice our age now, no longer an age of 60 that people will die from an age of 60. We actually live longer now to an age of 80, 90 and 100. So can you share with us the secret of combination between Eastern and Western so that you can be able to deliver a healthy lifestyle, but yet we age gracefully?
You know, that's the concept, Dana. You made a very important point. I call it not adding years to life, but also adding life to years. The concept right there that as we age, our body goes through a natural wear and tear process. We call it degeneration. That's a process which could be stalled or slowed down. If not in the future years, we could reverse it. But what we have seen over the years that our lifespan, especially in countries like Bangladesh, where I'm from, Vietnam, the longevity has increased a lot. Mm-hmm. A lot has to do with managing hygiene, nutrition, and sanitation. But beyond that horizon, there are a lot of other things which we implement. Our goals are, if we can have a magic wand and stop the aging process or the biological clock, you know,
we that would wish be, that.
We'd love to have that. I tried it myself. But the truth of the matter is, we know from scientific studies that diet, lifestyle, exercise, stress reduction, you know, those things and relationships, positive relationships, they do impact a great deal on your health and longevity. So the most important study actually was done in Japan. That's called the Japan Centennial Study. They looked at seniors, like centenarians or 100 plus years old. What they figured out that there were a few key elements which has been replicated over the years on all different studies. Those are actually diet, mm-hmm. sunlight, avoiding toxins, positive relationships, stress reduction, and most over is having mental aerobics or living in an environment which is stimulating to your brain and to your mind and to your spirit. So those are all the elements we have seen from those studies over and over again that it really impacts longevity in a positive way.
So what advice do you have to our audience at for you to list out all that important thing, family life, positive energy, food, diet, all of that. What is your advice of how them go about to start to with a healthy lifestyle, let's say today?
Okay, so that's a very interesting question. You know, like we could delve into it for hours, but I'll just encapsulate it and crystallize my thoughts. Diet, actually here in the Western world, we live in a pro-inflammatory diet. We know that inflammation is the key to all the chronic disease conditions. Mm-hmm. So if we actually can indulge ourselves into an anti-inflammatory diet that includes like vegetables, that dairy-free, you know, like food as much as possible, red meat, you know, seafood is great, lentils, vegetable proteins and vegetable fats, and if we can actually cut back on many of those elements that provokes inflammation, you know, we are pretty good. And the way we know it is from the Indo-Mediterranean diet heart study. We know that it reduces your risk for heart attacks and strokes by 55% if you actually indulge yourself into a Mediterranean diet. Now, about exercise, you know, aerobic exercise is good. 1 hour of exercise contributes to 2 hours of longevity. So if you are actually doing 10 hours of exercise a week, you're adding 20 hours of life. So then comes about, you know, stress reduction. Stress is the cortisol, is the battery acid that helps, that contributes to aging process. And there are a lot of ways we could manage stress. And most important thing, which is ignored in our part of the world with our jet set lifestyle, is relationships. Toxic relationships is worse than toxic food. You know, I always tell my wife that you cannot kill me with toxic food, but you can kill me with a toxic relationship.
But let me go into detail about toxic relationship. We're not just talking about toxic relationship between husband and wife, but we're also talking about relationship between friends, family, relative. And that's why a lot of talk show, they mention about, as we get older, we start to look at our list and we start to erase people that actually bring negative to our life, because exactly, it's the key to release all the stress that you indulge into your body that you don't need. Right, Dr. Nessa?
Absolutely. You know, you hit the nail right on the butt, Dana. This is the most important thing. There are certain people we cannot avoid in our life, but we should actually make it a point, because positive people, they exude a positive energy field. Mm-hmm. So when you are inside the positive energy field, you feel better. We know from studies actually that even a little bit of conflict is good, so long there is interdependence, you know, that's all that matters. Mm-hmm. If you look at the Harvard, you know, happiness study, done over 75 years, that's what it tells us. It's not even diet or your cholesterol level or your blood pressure. It's your relationships, a relationship that you look forward to, even despite certain conflicts, there is some interdependence. You know, that actually can promote longevity in the best way. The recent study that came out on social isolation is very, very grim. Like, obesity contributes to 30% increase in your mortality, right? If you are socially isolated, it's double the risk. That means 60% increased risk for mortality. So we have to kind of engage ourselves in a lifestyle that promotes positive relationships, positive aura, positive energy. And I can tell just by talking to you, Dana, you are exuding positive energy, and I feel so good.
Oh, thank you. I'm trying to do that for you today so that we can kind of experience it together. Positive energy always help our body regenerate and make us feel happy. And when we're happy, we glow from the inside out. And that's what we talk about, the inside out approach. Now, let me ask you, if a client come to you and said that they have a great diet, they eat a lot of veggie, they eat a lot of fruit, but they want some supplement. As we get older, we does need some supplement. What is the organic supplement that you would recommend to our audience that they can start taking today to really prolong the happiness of their life?
Right. That's a very interesting question. And let me, you know, like, elaborate. Let me touch in base. Let's go into a little granular level. Mm-hmm. We know that our soil, you know, we have treated it like dirt. You know, like I saw a sign right there on a bumper sticker, don't treat your soil like dirt. Because of commercial farming, our soils are devoid of nutrients. Mm-hmm. So what happens in reality, that even according to the RDA standards, our soil is depleted of magnesium, is depleted of vitamin B, which is crucial for your nerve health. So nowadays what we see, that even if you have food, that is foodless food, it does not have the proper nutritional value. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, that's the reason we have to supplement. So the most important supplement thing, which I consider, is like omega-3s, that's good for your brain and your heart. Vitamin D is crucial. It's not a vitamin, it's actually a steroid hormone, by the way. Magnesium is very important. You know, vitamin B is very important for our mood and our depression, for our mental health. It's crucial that we have adequate vitamin B. Vitamin C is very important. And depending upon certain issues, like if you have dementia, then you know you should take things like huperzine. If you want to have a good cardiac health and skin health, you take things like resveratrol. So there are a lot of things you can do to custom tailor according to your needs.
Perfect. So right today we just kind of summarize about the healthy lifestyle for a long life, the secret of long life. But I believe that as we go with VNTV, we could go into depth of each different sickness or disease that you can talk about and what the solution for it. Like I wanted to kind of ask you, we have met a doctor, a neurology doctor, and they said that they do a lot of research about Alzheimer's. Right. And they said that it's most of it depend on the food you eat, 60%, exactly. And the exercise. So it's really catered to everything that we talk about when right. It comes to sickness and disease. It's all revolving by two things: the food, we are what we eat, right. And also the exercise that we do. And so if today, if for our audience VNTV today, if we go home today, what do you think that they can take home at a list of things that they can start doing right now to improve their life?
Okay, so the most interesting phenomena is what we say in anti-aging medicine, that what is good for your brain is good for your heart.
Okay.
And whatever food that promotes blood flow to your organs, it slows down the aging process. So putting that in mind, you know, I will divide your questions into two components. The first component, you know, what we see in our brain, it actually, there's a neuropeptide, it's a protein we call brain-derived neurotrophic factor. We know a few things, like calorie restriction is good. You know, last year, the Japanese Nobel laureate, he described a process called autophagy. That means when you fast or you do calorie restriction, your body gets rid of a lot of the toxic proteins.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we know for sure that certain food we call brain superfood, like avocado, I call it God's butter. You know, blueberries, you know, I call God's candy. You know, like there are olive oil, extra virgin olive oil. You know, like cinnamon. You know, even sniffing cinnamon is good for your brain. It opens up the blood flow. You know, things like colored fruits, they have anthocyanidins and polyphenols. They are like the workers that repair your blood vessels. If you have any damage, it fixes it. Walnuts, you know, those kind of stuff. You know, like sockeye salmon, we know that fish is brain food. So whatever I'm describing is not only good for your brain, but good for your heart as well. But we actually have seen the major impact with exercise. Aerobic exercise also promotes brain-derived neurotrophic factor. And that actually stimulates connectivity in your brain, and that opens up your blood flow to your heart and other essential organs. So those two elements are very crucial for our health and longevity.
So I saved the best for last for today. So when we talk about anti-aging, I am very holistic and organic, and I love anything that non-invasive. But as an MD doctor like you, there are so many procedures out there that invasive, but yet it's really help to give them some help to really encourage them to maintain the anti-aging process.
Right.
So can you share with us what kind of procedure out there that will be safe for them to do to kind of enhance their beauty as they age for the anti-aging process, and also how to maintain that with a non-MD or non-injection based
right.
procedure to combine the both worlds to make that anti-aging slow down of anti-aging instead of having us age a little bit faster?
Very good. Interesting question. Let me tell you that, you know, our skin is the largest organ in our body, mm-hmm. which we can see,
yes.
right?
Mm-hmm.
You cannot hide your skin.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so your skin is a marker of your brain health, your gut health, your cardiac health. So let me give you an example. Like we Indians, we use a lot of curcumin. You know, curcumin root, you can juice it. The things you'll notice in your 2 weeks that your skin is going to give a glow. Your hair is going to get better. So what it tells me that, you know, if your skin is getting better, if you're having that healthy glow, that means it's also exacting changes inside your body, okay? So that's actually something very important. One of the things we also have seen, that resveratrol, Harvard study, that, you know, it actually promotes your skin to be younger. The resveratrol is a component we get on the red grape, the skin that has been extracted. It has proven. We know about omega-3 fish oils, you know, it has proven to slow down aging process, especially your brain aging. One of the things we have also seen that actually it can reverse aging, because the telomeres are at the tip of your chromosomes, right? So as it splices, as we age, you know, it contributes to aging. Interestingly, I know you guys drink a lot of green tea. You know, the green tea, it slows down the splicing of that telomere by like 4.6 kilobases a year. That means that a person, it translates to about 8 to 10 years of extra life, somebody who's drinking 6 cups of green tea. I mean, those are all scientifically proven from University of Ontario study. We have also seen the effects of meditation, you know, positive relationships. I've seen a lot of Vietnamese, by the way, they're in the 60s, their skin looks like 40s.
You know, because we use a lot of turmeric. So like you mentioned, Asian food include a lot of curcuma, turmeric. We do the same thing because the function of turmeric is pretty much inflammation. Help with the inflammation, correct? And also enhance the red blood cell to also give us a very beautiful skin to glow and from the outside.
Absolutely. No wonder, you know, pardon my personal bias, no wonder Asian women, they look so charming and beautiful.
Thank you.
Because of the curcumin, the spices, we call it healing spices. You know, they have very positive effects on your skin, your hair, your hormones. Yes, you know, it actually can regulate your youth hormones over the years. And actually, it actually is so good for your cardiac and brain health.
Thank you, Dr. Nasa. We're really excited to have you join VNTV, and we're looking forward for many more of the show so that we can share more about health, about medicines, about anything that we can do to really slow down the aging process. Thank you very much. Phương Dung xin kính chào quý vị khán giả ở VNTV. Để nếu quý vị có những câu hỏi gì thì trên màn hình sẽ có số phone và địa chỉ và website của Dr. Abu Nasser để quý vị có tham khảo thêm, và chúc quý vị một ngày vui vẻ hạnh phúc. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Nasser.
It's my pleasure.
Thank you.